Probably the first time Team Paradox made it to the championships. So that was San Diego competition, March 2010.
One of my favorite memories from high school is all of Little Shop, because it was a really good experience and everyone got to be like such a big family, and Annie was in it, and there was a lot of love. Another one of my favorite memories from high school is that one day that Lonnie and Kylie and Shelby and I all went shopping for formal dresses, and we were in the UTC and we went on all sorts of adventures, and we like pulled apart a plate and put it in like all the little holes in this one table, and we got people to like take pictures of us with it, and they were like, wow, that's so cool, that's like art. And it wasn't like art.
I don't always talk about my favorite high school memories on camera, but when I do, I like to talk about eating chips with Kylie and Sammy, performing in air bands, which we will do very shortly, winning engineering inspiration, and everything Annie has ever said.
Going to formal in a school bus? All the days when we would sit at the hill. I don't know. I'm always gonna remember it. I'm gonna remember clubs. I'm gonna remember a lot of clubs.
The night we attempted to stay overnight at a Wendy's, I think we made it to about 2:30, somewhere around there.
Was it Denny's?
It was Denny's. Did I say Wendy's? Mm-hmm. Denny's, of course. Oh. Our waiter was named Tim. He was way too happy for that time of the morning, way too energetic. I don't know, man. But we had to leave eventually, though, because we were all full. We couldn't really take it anymore. So we went to Cottonwood, and this guy came out of his trailer and tried to kick us out from playing Fish Out of Water. We went to Stagecoach, and we played Fish Out of Water there. For some reason, I think Cameron Inglis was like, let's just drive around Rancho Santa Fe. So we just like did that.
Oh, yeah.
Until like who knows when in the morning, and we ended up right at that golf course on Leucadia, right on that ridge there, and we tried to watch the sunrise. And I really remember that being like really remarkable, just imagining us all just standing up there, like half awake, trying to watch the sun through the clouds, which we could not possibly see. You know, it was really silly, but really picturesque in my mind. And then we all just got dropped back off at Suki's house. We watched Superman Returns, like really, really lazily, and then we slept until like noon. And it was just one of the awesomest days/nights I've ever had. I really loved 4th of July, the summer after my freshman year. Yes, I think Lonnie remembers because we were all over at her house.
Oh, and I loved that.
Her place in Del Mar, which had a beautiful view of the Del Mar fireworks, and we were all just sitting in the hot tub that was on her freaking roof. And we went swimming in Del Mar. It was just absolutely wonderful. When we all had dinner together, for some reason we all had roles as if we were in some sort of like fantasy kingdom. Yes, there were kings and queens and bards and lepers.
It was the mistress.
Mistresses.
And then you were the ferret. Oh,
then yeah. there was a ferret involved. It was really wonderful just how spirited and silly everyone was. In fact, I think every single 4th of July I've had has been a really great memory. The one I also had in Del Mar when we went to Dog Beach.
And we drank root beer out of a watermelon.
We drank root beer out of a watermelon that had Uncle Sam's face carved into it. And that was a really fun day as well. So I think 4th of July is one of my other really great memories.
One of my favorite memories of high school, and this was like a long time ago, was when we were having a sleepover at my house and Sammy is allergic to cats. And so we gave her NyQuil to get her to not be allergic to cats, like this one. And you shouldn't take NyQuil and try and stay awake. And we learned that because Sammy is silly.
So I think it was in sophomore year, and there was a Team San Diego Robotics beach bonfire down at La Jolla. And it was like one of the first times I think that maybe Tatiana got to like go out really late or something. And so we're like, okay, it's gonna be all cool. So it was like me and Tatiana and Sammy Nez, and we got stuck down there at like 11 at night until like 1 in the morning. And so we were just like sitting there, and we were just like outside the whole like beach area, and we're just like, okay,
who do we call now? But then these three guys came up in a truck and they just like stopped in the middle of the road and they, one of them rolled down his window and he's just like, I put a spell on you. And then he ran and then they just drove away. And it was like, that was totally directed at you, Tatiana. And it was silly, so yeah. And then also, at championships for robotics, Kyle was exposing his thighs. And then it was really funny because I think the favorite part of that was telling Zach that it was 5 a.m. and him finding out 2 hours later that it was 3 a.m. then. So yeah, that was really funny because it's still funny to say, what time is it, Zach? And he's like, shut up. Okay, so Aunt Dallagher just said Kyle putting on Elise's bra. And then I remembered Elise trying to dance like Kyle and, shoot, who was it?
Greg.
And Greg, when we were at the robotics competition, dance, Black Eyed Peas, whatever. And she was so silly.
Last year on the hill, the day before winter break, we took these plastic ornaments and we threw them up at the tree up on the hill, and we got some caution tape and we decorated it all up, and then we found a couch actually behind the storage unit and we dragged it up to the top of the hill and we sat on the couch underneath our Christmas tree and we took family pictures and it was so much fun and we sang carols. It was great.
I'm crying. I'm almost done because my time at SDA is just so powerful for me. A good memory is when the group that must not be named won Air Bands finally this year. We worked very hard on that dance and it was ridiculously fun. Noises off, also. Theater, just theater, but mostly noises off and I don't know, all my theater buddies, and I'll miss you.
Never sucked a dick, never got it. Like, there was that one time that we went camping, and like, everyone ate the same thing, and they couldn't figure out why they were feeling bad. Then suddenly everyone was having heart attacks, and we spent like, it was like me and Shelby, and everyone else was trying to go to sleep, and me and Shelby were just being like annoying as hell. And we were up to like, I don't know, it's gotta be like 4 or 5 a.m, making heart attack jokes, just like mid-sentence going, hey. And it was really funny. That was a good memory. And a huge camping trip where my mom like, and Stan's mom came, and we like went out to the middle of Palomar Mountain or whatever. That was a lot of fun. We had some good times. All those train trips we went on and shit. I don't have a favorite. There's a lot of fun things. There's a lot of fun things with a lot of different people.
I don't have any fond memories. I had a terrible high school experience.
Actually, that would work perfectly.
Would it?
Yeah.
I feel like
that's Shelby. Yeah.
Everyone who knows me would be like, you did? Why were you so loud then?
Okay. I biked over to Grant's house because he was having a garage sale. And there was Suki there with Grant, and I saw a chicken suit there. And
I said, Sammy, I want you to have this chicken suit. But the only way you're going to be allowed to keep it is if you bike home in it.
I got in the chicken suit, I got on my bicycle, and as I was leaving, Suki said, you know there's a big hole in the butt, right?
There truly wasn't a hole.
I found out at the end that Suki was lying, that there wasn't a hole in the butt. And so I rode and I rode past Stagecoach with a bunch of children yelling, chicken, at me. Skaters giggling, and I rode into my neighborhood, and people would stop from their car washes and just look. And I finally made it home, and I opened the door, and my dad just like looked down at me from the top of the stairs, and he was like, okay.
One time when we were roomies at in Las Vegas,
don't bring this up.
She used my conditioner, and I was like, Sammy, you know my conditioner was mayonnaise, right?
It was April Fool's Day.
It was also April Fool's Day. And I was like, oh, I also replaced the rest of your conditioner with mayonnaise. I'm not really sure what the situation was, if I recall, but all of the conditioner was and shampoo was now mayonnaise.
I couldn't escape.
None of it was actually mayonnaise.
It kind of smelled like it, though. That's why I believed her.
But it was like a placebo effect.
If you think you're going to
smell
it,
it smelled like mayonnaise.
It smelled weird.
She wasn't safe anywhere because I told her wherever she would go, she would have to wash her hair with mayonnaise.
It was disgusting. It was horrible.
It was awesome.
awesome. I didn't like it. I didn't like that. That was bad. That was a bad April Fool's Day joke.
My memory is also my most embarrassing high school memory. This is the first time I hosted the prom fashion show. Going up there, going to think I just need to do it for like 2 minutes, end up winging it for 20 minutes. I was scared so much, but I did it. And I'm so happy I did it again this year, and it was really fun. Thanks, Claire, for that.
It was like watching Up for the second time, and very happy. Josh and Lonnie, and sophomore summer was awesome. Everyone was over at Kylie's, and I think my favorite part of that summer was the mountain. Climbing up that mountain was sort of empowering, and it was just togetherness, and went on a journey, and I hope our graduation is great. Bye-bye.
Colors and promises. How- You and I were friends from outer space, afraid to let go, the only two who understood this place. And as far as we know, we were way before our time, as bold as we were blind. Just another perfect mistake, another bridge to take on the way of letting go. The same goodbye, this is just where love goes, when words aren't warm enough to keep away the cold. Oh no, the same goodbye, it's not where our story is, but I know you can't be mine, not the way you've always been. As long as we've got time, then the same goodbye. Oh no, this ain't goodbye. We were stars up in the sunlit sky, but no one else could see. Neither of us thought to ever ask why. It wasn't meant to be. Maybe we were way too high. Space, afraid to let go, the only two who understood this place. And as far as we know, the same goodbye.